by Villa. But that ball, by the time it got to Villa at home plate, it was such a great jump. There was no way they were going to get Pacello. He was beyond halfway. It's one of those times where you just have to eat that nut and throw it.
Pacello is 14th seed. And now we get another slow walk out to the mound here. Because they're trying to give Frias a little bit of time here to get ready. And again, he is a starter. So this is a whole different situation for Frias as far as getting ready to pitch you. So will he be as sharp early as he might be if he had a little more time to warm up? He's only pitched in relief one time this year.
And what Larry's alluding to, starting pitchers, you got your routine. You know that maybe it takes you 45 minutes before first pitch is when you want to start getting into a routine. Maybe that's 30 minutes. When you're trying to come into a game as a reliever, you only have minutes.
Yeah. There were 131 pitches on Friday. And so here we are on Tuesday, and he's warm enough to come back into the game again. He's a senior. This is the end of the line for him here. And so, the tying run on out of second base, and we count 1-0 on Tanksley. Hold down the third baseline foul. One ball, one strike.
That's probably going to be it.
A little bit
more time to have him warm up.
No. So we are 2.5 hours into this game. We're in the bottom of the fifth, and this is, I've lost count of how many pitchers have gone in this game.
Eight.
Oh, more than
that. Nine. Number 10 coming in.
Yeah. Six for Southeast, and this will be the fourth for Faulkner. But I am fairly confident in saying this will be the last for Faulkner. Their ace is coming on, Antonio Frias, here in the last of the fifth. Two in for the Grenadiers, and they're within one, and the tying run is at second base.
Frias, the most important.
All right, so we have this conversation going on between the umpires, and Bob, what do you think's happening here?
Well, I don't believe they're going to allow that switch to happen right now because of the visits to the mound. There are two visits to the mound and with the same at-bat. And so you can't make that change at that moment. Home plate umpire should have actually stopped him from crossing going out. And so what's going to happen is we're going to have a new head coach because, unfortunate, and that's where I think that's preventative maintenance for the umpire as well. He should have stopped that. Because he crossed and went out again, and it was the same at bat, now he's going to have to be ejected. Now, my problem with that is, he went and looked, we had a replay on it, the head coach walked out, and he looked at the home plate umpire, asked for the change to be made, home plate umpire allowed it, that should have been preventative maintenance, and he should have been able to say at that point, no, you can't go out, it's in the same at bat. But because he allowed it, I'm almost thinking that I've got the argument to be able to stay in the ball game. Because, I mean, I do remember watching him walk out before he crossed the line. He did go, I'm going to make a change, and the home plate umpire granted that. Again, we're in the same at-bat. And if he had crossed the line without asking in the same at-bat, Larry, that's two charged timeouts, and he's ejected. But again, I know for a fact I watched him get granted permission to cross the line and make the change before he crossed. So I think the home plate umpire almost has to own this a little bit and almost redo, like deny it, just have the at-bat continued here with Correa.
With the coach staying in the game.
With the coach staying in the game, because I know he allowed it. And I'm not sure we really had the opportunity to run a replay as he was going out to make the change, but I know he stopped before, which is appropriate. Looked at the home plate umpire, pointed, home plate umpire allowed it.
So now they're going to talk to the Faulkner coach. One of the umpires being dispatched to the bullpen.
And right now you can't talk to the head coach. You technically is hanging out, but
well, was the head coach though the one that went out to the mound?
It was a pitching coach. So the pitching coach, the pitching coach went to make that change. You're right. That head coach is out there right now in McCarthy.
So three of the umpires talking to Patrick McCarthy, the head coach for Faulkner. One of the umpires dispatched to the bullpen.
So they can make that change with Frias, but not at this moment.
And they're explaining to somebody down there.
That might be maybe the umpire, one of
the observer
for the umpires coming through. So the change technically can be made. You can make a change in the same at-bat. You just can't have two. You can't go out twice in one at-bat. You would have had to make that change prior to, which I know I saw him do.
And so Correa had left the game and had probably checked out mentally, and now he's going to have to come back in the game here.
Yeah.
So let's see what this young man can do. And now they're going to co-explain to Ben Reel, the head coach for IU Southeast, what the ruling is.
And he's got a great argument here, but again, just from my observation, and I really believe I watched that clearly, the home plate umpire allowed that to happen. He asked for permission. He just didn't walk out. So by the letter of the law, Coach Reel has got it correct.
So now we'll just see whether the pitching coach has been ejected out of this game. You may not know whether he has or he hasn't, because for Correa, I'm surprised they're not allowing him to throw some warm-up tosses here.
Now, they might, again, allow Correa just to exit and for the change to be made, but we're going to see if anything else happens here. Looks like he's staying in the game, and I don't know that we're going to get a signal that says, my bad, or what's happening.